You enjoy writing, I can
I
feel.
I love it. Yes, yeah. It's a passion. But it's also hard work, and mm-hmm. I have been writing all my life, but only it was first at the age of 40 I made it a living. Today yeah. is a living.
Yeah.
This is what I do. And the second I made it a living, a few things changed. Some of the romance disappeared.
Yeah.
And left was the hard work. But I do mm. love it, and I write every day, 7 days a week, and it's something that I must do.
How do you work with translators?
I don't work much with them, because the publishing house will find a translator, and I don't speak with them. Only mm. if they have questions or problems, they might call me, and I try to help them out. But I don't have much to do with them, and of course, I cannot even check the books. Of course, I can check this one, because yeah. I can understand English. But when it comes to Polish and Italian and Spanish, mm. and I can't. I don't know what they're doing, so I just pretend.
Yeah. Now, do you do a book tour in those other countries?
Yes.
Then?
Not so all of them, but in around Europe, of course.
Yeah. Even if you don't speak the language, you're going and saying, smiling and saying, yes, right.
Yes. Yeah.
When this book was translated in England, is there a difference in the English from American English to England's English?
Yeah, they told me there is a slightly difference.
Really?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
And on this tour, I have brought the English version, because it's easier for me to read English than American, because was taught in school.
Yeah.
So,
is there a large literary world in Norway?
No, it's not large. It's a small people, small language. So everybody knows everybody. Yeah. You might say.
Yeah.
Yes.
But you still have the history of Ibsen.
Of course, we have. Yeah. And Hamsun.
Yeah. Mm. And who else is writing the way you do in Norway?
Oh, we have several quite clever crime writers, I think. The most successful ones are, in fact, women. We have male writers as well. Yeah. They don't do that well, except for one, maybe. But I don't quite do the same thing as they do.
Yeah.
I mean, my this genre is full of psychopaths and serial killers.
Yeah.
And I don't do that.
No, you do character study.
Yes.
You do where character drives the plot, not the plot drives the character.
Yeah, you might say so.
Yeah. Yeah. Karen, it's just a wonderful book. I will hope that we will get to see the television version of this.
Yes, that would be nice. It's quite good, actually.
Yeah.
Yes.
When they do they do it in one show, or is this over a couple of weeks?
Over a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
3 or 4 weeks.
And do you have any say in who's cast or how it's done?
No, I read the script.
Uh-huh.
And if there's something I don't like, I tell them, and maybe they will change a few things. Mm. But when it comes down to the other stuff, like casting or locations, and I have nothing to do with that. But it has been successful, and the series has got a couple of prizes, TV prizes.
I only wish I could speak the language, because I loved your country when I visited
Yes.
Yeah.
That's nice.
Yeah, Bergen and
Bergen is beautiful.
Yes. And then, really, as I said to you, the tundra is magnificent. It feels like you're on the moon.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. And also, isn't that where the white water, the heavy water comes from up there, that they later used for atomic and nuclear work from up in the tundra of Norway, where they had what they call heavy water?
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Sorry. Now I understand you.
Yeah.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah.
Tungt vann, we say in Norwegian.
Okay.
Yes.
And how do you say thank you?
Takk.
Takk. Mm. May I say that to you, and will you sign your book?
Of course I will.
Thank you. And if you'd like a copy of our newsletter, Good Books, send me a stamped, self-addressed envelope to Good Books, P.O. Box 69-1640, Los Angeles, California 90069. Look for our column in the Beverly Hills Courier. For us on the web at www.ConnieMartinson.com. And when this program airs in certain cities, well, Karen can see it in Norway because they will be streaming it. Streaming being, if she's online on her computer, she can log in to www.ConnieMartinson.com and get a chance to see the program. That's part of the great future that we are all living in, as well as email me at talksbooks@lycos. We'll tell you about some other books we've liked recently. Faye Brigoli has written Cracked Pomegranate. My birthday was when the pomegranate grew ripe. It is a beautiful book about Iran. She was brought up there. She now lives in San Francisco. But this is Iran 28 years ago, when her father wanted to marry the daughter, who her elder sister was 13. Because at 13, you marry. Arranged marriages. The other boy, the boy's family would come with gifts on a tray. Well, what if she saw someone and fell in love? Too bad. She had to do keep the family honor and marry whom her father picked out. Then there is a second story that is a level in this about a woman who had been attacked, a married woman, and because she was attacked going to the bathhouse, it was her fault. She is attacked by the religious people. It's the son of one of the leaders who has attacked her. Not his fault. She is to be stoned to death. I mean, it's horrendous what was done in the name of religion against women. I did say that I felt half the Shah's problem was giving women rights and education. That, you know, how are you going to keep them down on the farm after they've seen some liberty? Ending up, Faye does come to America, and she has family back in Iran, and she said her mother still controls the brother's wife. Interesting that life has not changed, even with a daughter who's independent. Support your local library, go in, take out a card. If you've never read any of Ibsen's plays, go back and read A Doll's House, because at the end, Nora slams that door because she is a bigger world out there. We'll see you next time. Thank you very much.
Thank you.